Hi, I'm Roman and I help design and develop the Google I.O. 2014 Android app. In this video, I'll dive into how we use the new material design approach to build a visually striking, consistent, and adaptive Android app for this year's conference. So what exactly is material design? At first glance, it may just seem like a new visual design language full of bright colors and subtle shadows. But it's really much more than that. It's a system that we pioneered that informs all of our visual interaction and motion design decisions across mobile, desktop, wearables, and beyond. Now, every year at Google I.O., our team spends several whole months working on the conference app. We do this for two reasons. First, it's obviously a great companion for the developers attending the event and those tuning in at home. Second, and arguably more importantly, it serves as a reference app for Android design and development best practices. Now, this year's app uses material design and features of the L Developer Preview to present content in a rational, consistent, adaptive, and beautiful way. Let's take a look at some of the decisions and outcomes that informed the app's design. In material design, surfaces and shadows play an important role in conveying the structure of your app. The material design spec outlines a set of layout principles that help guide decisions like where shadows should appear and what is drawn on each surface. For example, here's our first iteration of tabs in the My Schedule screen. It was problematic for a number of reasons. The single shadow below the action bar conveys that there are two sheets of paper, one for the action bar and another for the tabs and schedule contents. The problem is that the bottom sheet is too complex. The ink that represents the contents of a surface should be pretty simple. Here, ink is doing too much work, painting not only text and icons, but borders and background colors. The result is visual noise. Our final iteration was much stronger, creating a clear separation between chrome and content and letting the ink focus on painting only the important stuff, things like text, icons, and accent strips. Another area where surfaces played a role in our design thinking was the detail screen. In our first release, as you scroll, the top banner crossfaded between the session image and the session color. Our concern, though, was that this design bent the physics of material design too far. It's as if the text was sliding along a surface whose transparency changed throughout the animation. A better approach, which we introduced in an update to the app on June 25th, was to create a shorter surface below the image, onto which the title text was printed. This surface had a more stable opacity. Before scrolling, the surface is adjacent to the one containing the body text, forming what we call a seam. And as you scroll, this surface and the floating action button attached to it rises above the body text, allowing the text to scroll beneath it. This aligns better with the physics in the world of material design, and the end result is a more coherent visual interaction and motion story for our users. Now, another key principle of material design is that interfaces should be bold, graphic, and intentional, and that the foundational elements of print design should guide visual treatments. Color plays a huge role in making that happen. In material design, UI color palettes generally consist of one primary and one accent color. Large color fields, like the action bar background, for example, take on the 500 shade of the primary color, while smaller areas, like the status bar, can use a darker shade, like the 700 value. The accent color is used more subtly throughout the app to call attention to key elements. The resulting juxtaposition of a tamer primary color and a brighter accent color gives the app a bold, colorful look without overwhelming the app's actual content. In the I.O. app, we actually chose to use two accent colors used in various situations. Most accents were pink 500, while the more conservative light blue 500 was a better fit for the Add to Schedule button, which was often adjacent to session colors. And speaking of session colors, we color the detail screen based on the session topic. For example, Android sessions are green. This gives the screen that bold and intentional look. And when choosing our topic colors, we use the Material Design color palette, which contained dozens of great color options. We also needed to make sure that each color contrasted well enough with the floating action button and session images. Here's our test graphic that let us visualize this contrast. Finally, we ensured that topic colors had a consistent brightness. Desaturating our test file when choosing the colors helped in that process. Now, another foundational element of print design that's important in successful material design is layout, and more specifically, margins and what we call key lines. Now, from previous years of the I/O app, we'd already been accustomed to using a 4-dip grid for sizing things. For example, our buttons and list items were 48 dips tall. However, the guidance on key lines from Material Design was new to us. After we started adhering to the spec, and in particular, aligning titles and other text to that 72-dip key line, we immediately felt that clean, print-like rhythm in our screens. Adhering to the key line allowed for very fast scanning of UI text and information on our screens. Gestalt principles for the win. Now, while we're on the subject of layout, remember that Material Design applies across many device types. It's right there in the principles. A single underlying design system organizes interactions in space. Each device reflects a different view of the same underlying system. Now, luckily, the spec offers some great solutions for designing across multiple screen sizes. For example, many of the screens in the I/O app represent collections of sessions. For these situations, the system offers a number of containers, like lists, grids, and cards. Each of these can be used across different screen sizes to represent collections of data. We originally thought to use cards to represent session items. It's a pretty natural choice. But in some cases, we wanted to conserve space by overlaying text and images. This simpler, more homogeneous presentation was less appropriate for cards. The card shadows and corners would hinder the scannability in this context. We thought a grid would be a better choice here. With grids, we could vary the number of columns based on available screen width, and each grid tile could take on different aspect ratios. The resulting presentation was very flexible and worked great not only on phones, but also 7-inch and 10-inch tablets. Finally, there's a crucial element that ties everything together, and that's motion. While a big part of the motion story of Material Design is in transitions between screens, apps can truly delight users when motion is used in ways beyond the obvious. Let's take a look at some of the delightful motion we introduced in the app. First, touch feedback ripples. They're super, super satisfying. They're also built in as soon as you switch to the material theme in L. But we wanted to make sure they looked really good on any background. So we customized ripple colors for many elements to ensure the ripples were visible but still subtle, regardless of the background. We also used both the bounded and unbounded styles where appropriate. But my personal favorite detail, hands down, in the app is the floating button that adds or removes a session to your schedule. On touch, a little ink ripple reveals a new background color, and the plus symbol spins and transforms into a check mark. Finally, while it's a bit hard to tell in this animation, if you press and hold the button, its shadow grows, almost like the button is lifting up to meet your finger. The end result is you end up pressing the button a few times just to see its delightful tricks again and again. I do it many times a day. So those are some of the design decisions we made for the I/O 2014 Android app. Material Design influenced everything, including surfaces, shadows, color, layout, and motion in the app. Overall, the system played a huge role in helping us create a visually striking, consistent, and adaptive Android app for the conference. Now make sure to check the Material Design spec at google.com/design for more on this new design approach and how it can help you improve your apps. And if you're an Android developer, check out the code for the I/O app on GitHub to see how the design is implemented both for Android L and for earlier versions. Thanks.